experience on this Sunday morning. Those of you who have your Bibles, please turn with me to the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 10, notice verse number 36. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 36. Hebrews chapter 10, verse number 36. For ye have need of patience, that after ye have done the will of God, ye might receive the promise. And from that passage of scripture this morning, I want to talk about the need for patience.
Oh, that's good.
The need for patience. As we move forward through this pandemic, it is clear to me that we need patience on all levels of our lives.
So true, so true.
Patience is a person's ability to wait something out or endure something tedious without getting riled up. If the truth be told, it takes a lot of patience to deal with a toddler's temper tantrum, or to build a house out of toothpicks. Have patience. Means you can remain calm even when you've been waiting forever, or dealing with something painstakingly slow, or trying to teach someone how to do something and they just don't get it. It involves acceptance, tolerance, and it is usually easier to have when there's something in it for you at the end. And so this morning, let me share some areas of need for patience. First of all, patience in suffering. Patience in suffering. James chapter 5. Verse 11 says, ye have heard of the patience of Job. Job is a model for us. The Bible tells us that Job was righteous and godly, blameless and upright, a man who feared God and shunned evil. Job lived a good life, but God chose Job to show us what patience should look like. Job went from having a good life to a life of loss. Amen. He went from having a good life to a life of loss. Loss of wealth. Loss of children. Loss of health. Loss of confidence from his wife and friends. In other words, a loss of the good life to a life of suffering. But Job was patient in suffering.
Yes.
And in doing so, he won the approval and blessing of God through his trust and determination. some Bible readers who know that it was Job, while in the midst of suffering, Job said, though he slay me, yet shall I trust in him. There's no question about it. Job was a man greatly tested by God, but even more greatly blessed by God. Good God, yes, he was. And so I come to encourage us this morning, we should also be patient in suffering. Amen. We should look for its purpose and seek to glorify God through it, even in the midst of our suffering. We need to seek its purpose, and then we need to seek it to glorify God while we're going through our suffering.
Yeah.
Here it is. Suffering is a way for God to display his power and glory. Don't miss it. Suffering can mean that God is wonderfully at work in a person's life, producing something miraculous. My God. Not too long ago, one of our members, one that we know very well, Sister Delphine Bike. I stopped by one day, amen, knowing that every day she suffers with pain in her life. But to my amazement, when I walked into the house, there she was in the kitchen. There she was in the kitchen, not only in the kitchen, but she was in her wheelchair. And she went from the refrigerator to the stove, to the storage bin. Amen. Not just operating in suffering, but she was operating in the miraculous power of God. I see somebody in a wheelchair in suffering, but yet she was going on by her pain. Your God, and God was empowering her to run her life. Oh God, as if she had 2 days, she only had 1 day, but she had a God on her side. Bless his name. Secondly, patience in sorrow. Patience in sorrow. Psalms 41 reads, I waited patiently for the Lord, and he heard my cry. Amen. I waited patiently for the Lord, and he heard my cry. Jesus was a man of sorrow. He bore deception. He bore disgrace and death with patience. Did you hear me? He bore deception, disgrace, and death with patience, also with compassion, also with forgiveness.
Hallelujah.
Isaiah said, he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. Jesus was patient in sorrow. And I just thought I'd encourage somebody to know that we should be patient in sorrow. We should endure trials. We should endure troubles. We should endure testings as Jesus did. Hallelujah. Sorrow. Ephesians 4:32 tells us, here it is, be ye kind one to another, tender hearted, forgive. one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. Be patient in sorrow.
Yeah.
Amen. Fourthly and finally, patient in setbacks. Patience in setbacks. Psalms 37 and 7. Psalms 37 and 7 reads, rest in the Lord and wait patiently for Him.
Endured, he obtained the promise.
believers, our service should be performed as unto the Lord. Let me help somebody right here. The more we do, the more criticism we often receive from others. Amen. So don't let it affect you as if you don't know. Expect it. Just expect it and serve God more fervently. Give them something to hate on you for. Serve God. Hallelujah. Oh God. Perseverance is needed when results are slow in coming. You keep on doing good works and planting good seed. In spite of what they say, you shall obtain the promise. You shall reap if you faint not. Amen. Let your service be as unto the Lord. Then you shall reap what you sow. Amen. Let me close with this hymn. Trust and obey.
Trust and obey.
When we walk with the Lord in the light of His Word, what a glory He sheds on the way. While we do His good will, He abides with us still, and with all who will trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no to be happy in Jesus, but to trust and obey. Not a burden we bear, not a sorrow we share, but our toil He doeth richly repay. Not a grief or loss, not a frown or a cross, but is blessed if we trust and obey. Trust and obey. Trust and obey. Hallelujah. For ye have need of patience, that after ye have done the will of God, ye might receive the promise. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord